Hi there, I'm Greg Nader with Sonnax, and today we're going to be talking about our 68 RFE Smart Tech Overdrive Clutch Housing Kit. Generally, this is a very simple kit to install, but there's five critical areas you need to get right to make sure you have a great outcome, and we're going to be covering those today. The first is the inner retainer housing to make sure you have the correct one. Number two is inspecting the input clutch hub for wear. Then we have the proper installation of our adapter sleeve, checking of all the clutch clearances through the unit, and finally prepping the bolts for installation with Loctite. With the inner retainer, all 68 RFEs should have been built with the late inner retainer. Now the early retainer that was used on 45s and 545s is a little bit different, and the snap ring positions are different, and that ends up affecting the clutch clearances. And you have to use the late retainer with our kit to have a good outcome. And the way to tell the difference is with the chamfer on the upper retaining ring groove for the underdrive overdrive apply plate. And on these early retainers, the chamfer is a little bit smaller, kind of a normal looking chamfer. And on the late ones, it's a much larger, a very exaggerated chamfer that actually aids in getting the snap ring in past the larger step on the apply plate. So it's critical that you have this late style retainer when using our kit. Next, we want to check the input clutch hub for wear. And there's a few areas that you can accumulate wear on these. And we're going to start with this diameter right here. And there's a precision ground diameter on the input shaft that actually centers the clutch hub to the shaft and the support journal where the input shaft is supported. And on these high mileage diesels, you can get a little bit of a step worn in there. So it's normal for the input shaft to have splines that are a bit of a slip fit, but it's this diameter right here. And if you get a step worn there, you definitely want to be replacing this. And it's hard to see. You have to get in there with a mirror and a flashlight. But you definitely want to be checking that. Additionally, you can have wear of the splines themselves, and then the sealing ring bore, anywhere that you can feel with your fingernail or that you can see, you definitely want to be replacing it, and especially watch out for the second and third sealing rings because those are the ones that seal the overdrive clutch oil. So the adapter ring actually installs onto the inner retainer housing, increasing the diameter, which allows for the larger piston apply area here. And when you're installing it, what you want to do is take your old overdrive piston, which is just the perfect installation tool, you put it right on here, put it in your press, and press that down. Once it's installed, you want to make sure that the expander ring is fully seated all the way down onto here. And then we'll come in with our staking tool and just put a little stake in there, and that'll lock the inner retainer in place so there'll be no concern with it ever moving. So from here on out, use your normal assembly processes until you get to the clearance checks. And also don't forget to pre-soak the clutches in ATF plus 4. So I want to talk about snap rings because we get a lot of calls on this and it's something to pay attention to. Now this kit eliminates the two snap rings for the overdrive reverse backing plate, but it keeps the stock snap rings down below. And that's the 60,000th thick number 4 snap ring and the 95,000th tapered number 5 snap ring for the underdrive overdrive apply plate. These are the same as OE, so we just reuse those. So we have the overdrive housing built up to the point of the underdrive overdrive apply plate with the snap rings installed and the underdrive clutches in there. And this is the point where we start checking clutch clearances. And having the proper clutch clearance is important for your CVI values, open clutch lubrication, and overall durability of the system. So it's really important to get the clutch clearances set properly and use the right procedure. And that procedure starts with the proper air pressure for air checking the clutches. Specification is 20 PSI. You can do that with a simple little regulator system. And then you can air check the clutches through your pump assembly. And this is a stator assembly that we built into a test fixture that we use here for some of our in-house testing. And today we're going to be using the OEM test tool for checking clutch clearances. So we're going to start with putting the overdrive clutches in. And these are the custom BorgWarner frictions, double-sided frictions, and regular steels. And to adjust the clearances for this system, With the bolt-on plate, we have the shims for setting clearance. So when you're first setting it up, you'll install one shim, and this will allow you to either remove one shim to tighten clutch clearance up, or to add the second shim to increase clearance. Now, adding a third shim is not a good idea because that'll move the clutches up the clutch hub where they're at risk of falling off, and it makes setting the reverse clearances a real pain. So no third shim, all right? So with the one shim installed for initial test, install the backing plate, and just four bolts are okay at this point. Okay, and now with a magnetic base dial indicator, we can mount that right to the input clutch hub. And you want to make sure you get this set far enough down that you capture all the travel. And we're going to just set this right here. And we're going to air test the overdrive clutch. And that's just about 65 thousandths of travel. That's at the high end of the clutch clearance range. So in this case, we'll take it back apart, we'll remove the one shim, and when we do our final assembly, that'll tighten clearances up by about 15 thousandths of an inch, so they'll be right at 50 thousandths of an inch, which is a great clearance for this setup. And from there, we will do our final assembly. So now for final assembly, one of the most critical things is getting the bolts properly installed and tightened so that there's no chance of them coming working their way loose, all right? And to do that, we want to make sure that all the oil residue is removed from both the threaded holes and the screws themselves. So what I like to do is with a little brake wash, put a little bit in each hole as I'm taking care of a few things around the bench and let those soak in there for a while. And then I'll do the same thing. I'll come over and I'll spray the bolts. And what we want to do is get all the oil off there so that Loctite can really do its job. So once I've filled the holes with brake wash, blow them out. And I like to do that two times just to make sure that there's no residue in there. Then you want to come along with your high strength red Loctite or equivalent. And you want to put a little bit on each hole. Not a lot. You don't want to get too much in there because that can actually create a hydraulic lock when you put the bolt in and give you a false torque reading. So just a little bit on each threaded hole and then a little bit on each screw as well. Now, if the unit's been assembled before, you might have some Loctite residue either on this surface or this surface. And it's very important to go in and make sure that both surfaces are perfectly clean. Now in this case, we have no shim because that's what we needed to get our clutch clearances set correctly. Then we're going to set the plate down and then start putting the screws in. So the torque spec is 52 inch pounds. And initially, you want to start at a lower value, say 35 inch pounds, and go around once. And then go back around and do your final torque at 52 inch pounds. Okay, we're going to start off in a little bit of a star pattern. And then we'll reset that. So I like to go around one more time just to make sure nothing got missed, but you also want to make sure that you don't over tighten anything. So at this point, everything is done. You got the kit built up. All the threaded holes are cleaned, Loctited, and torqued to spec, so it's nice and secure for the long haul. All that remains to be done is to install the reverse clutches. The clearance on those is set with selective snap rings. Now, those can be hard to source. Do keep in mind that the lower snap ring from the underdrive, overdrive apply plate, that snap ring, if you have any extras, can be used in the reverse location to help set those clearances. And from there, just install the input shaft, clutch hubs, and bearings, and you got the whole assembly ready to drop into your 68 RFE. So those are our tips and suggestions for assembling this. As you can see, it's pretty easy, and it really works great for the overdrive on the 68 RFE. If you have any questions we didn't cover here, feel free to reach out to our tech support. We'd love to hear from you and answer any questions you might have.